Today, we're going to be going over DaVinci Resolve and how to speed up your workflow from making custom templates so you don't have to go through the whole process of setting up your different bins, your color management, your settings, stuff like that, to how to pull selects using the speed editor as fast as possible, and then stacking two timelines to drag and drop your selects right onto your hero video. Now, I've tried making this video a couple times and it's been on the longer side. You guys are just gonna have to bear with me. However, by bearing with me, it's gonna save you so much time. So let's get right into it. Now, first things first, when we're creating these custom templates, you could customize them any which way you want. You could have a dedicated one for multicam interviews, social media, YouTube clients, editing your personal content. You could fully customize and have as many of these templates as possible. So what I'm gonna go over is how to customize them, how to set up all the different bins, projects, how to even add different labeled tracks with presets on them and stuff like that. And then I'll get over to the next two tips once we get through this. So what I want you to do is open up the project viewer and hit new project and label it whatever you want to name it. I'm going to name it 2025 Resolve 16x9 main template. I don't know, whatever you guys want to name it, and then just hit enter. So if you're doing it for a specific type of template, name it that so you know what it is every time you're opening it up. Now, the first thing we always do whenever we open up a brand new project is go to the bottom right corner of Resolve for our master project settings, basically. Here, adjust everything you normally would, whether it's your timeline resolution, if you're into color grading and you want to pick the different color management and color options for your color spaces like ASIS, wide gamut, color manage, go ahead, input everything you always do, and then hit save. Now, once we have that done, what we want to do is create some custom bins. So if your media pool isn't open on the edit tab, hit the top left corner media pool, and now in this section, we could right click, hit new bin, and start typing our bins. So take a moment to create all the different bins you normally set up, and if you don't, wait just a second so I could go over the ones that I create. All right, so I'm done creating my different bins. For one, I have footage, two, audio, three, music, four is my assets, so any overlays, graphics, logos, stuff that the client provides me with goes into there. Number five is my timelines. I want my timelines staying organized so they're not just created in different random folders. And then lastly, we have our selects. So that's gonna be what we're gonna be pulling with shortly using the speed editor. Now, inside my footage folder, if I double click on it, you see multiple cameras. I got the FX6, FX3, Komodo X, Pocket 3, Action 5, and then Drone. And then I went another step more. Inside Drone, we have Inspire, Mavic, and FPV because we use all those different types of drones. So you guys get the point. Organize your bins as much as possible. Now, the next thing I want you to do, because we're going to start creating our different timelines now, is to click on the timeline bin that we have. So as we create the timelines, they will populate in here and they'll always be in here if we need to pull one up, say if we close one. The other thing I want you guys to do is hover over this button right here, the timeline view options, click it, and click on displayed stack timelines. This will make sense in a little bit, but for the sake of this setup tutorial, I want you guys already having that done. Now, what we could do, if you're on a Mac, hit Control N. If you're on PC, Alt N. And now this brings up our basic new timeline. What I'm gonna label this is 16x9, and then I'm gonna decheck Use Project Settings, go to Format, and now here is where we could fine tune everything else. So say you want to edit off of a 4K timeline, you could drop on down the menu and go to 3840x2160, set up the timeline how you want it, label it, and then we're gonna hit create. Notice how the timeline just populated now in our timeline folder, and now we have one right here on our editor. Now let's create a vertical option. So I'm on the Mac, so once again, Command N, and I'm gonna name this vertical. We're gonna deselect, use project settings, go up to format, and now all we have to do is invert the ratio by clicking this box, use vertical resolution. Now we can hit create and boom, here's our vertical video. Now, another thing that I edit a lot of are ads, or a lot of content that we create for clients, campaigns, agencies, are ads that get rolled out on Meta and Instagram. Those are usually a one by one, that square. So what we want to do, I'm going to label this one by one, deselect use project settings, go up to format, and then we're just going to type in 1080 by 1080. And that'll give us our square, right? Now we have our one by one, so now we can make the ads. Let's do a 4x5 option. I don't know if anyone's requesting any 4x5s, but it might happen. So same thing as the 1x1, we're gonna go over to format, but instead of 1080 by 1080, we're gonna do 1080 by 1350. And then we're gonna hit enter, and this will give us that little 4x5 crop. And last but not least, command N, we're gonna label this selects. Now I always pull my selects 16x9, so it's already at default in 1080. I'm gonna hit enter. If you wanna do it vertical, do it. I never shoot vertical unless it's an absolute must and the client's demanding it. I've only done it twice. I like having the option to do tutorials like this one or use the footage, make a director's cut that's 16x9 even though it's vertical. I don't see the loss in quality. It's getting compressed, getting uploaded and all that jazz. So it is what it is. With that rant out of the way, we're almost done. All right, now the last thing we want to do before we save, say, the project and everything so that we could use this template ongoing is we can also add different video and audio tracks to these timelines. So say on this 16x9, I'm going to hover over this section right here, this little window, right click, add track, and let's add three of them. Say I'm making an interview one for three camera setup interviews. I can click on this video section and label it A cam. I could go on video two, B cam, and video three, which is actually, I kind of flipped it and it'll make sense in just a second. This will be C cam. The reason why I want my A cam as the third video track is so that's always above, then B and then C below, so that as I'm going through, I could color code each camera and I know my A cam's always at the top of the footage. So as I'm cutting it, whether you're using the multi-viewer, multi-cam editor, or you're just cutting it up manually, you know where your tracks are. Now, another cool thing is I like adding different audio tracks. So I will have sometimes 20, 30 different layers. It really depends on how extensive my sound design is. But in this case, we're just gonna add five of them so I could show you how I normally label these. So audio one is always my dialogue. So I'll either put voice or dialogue. Audio two is SFX, so sound effects. Audio three, sound effects. For audio four, that's my ambience. So I'll put an AMB, so room tone, light wind and breeze, or just any like noises that are just there, ceiling fans, I'll put them on an ambient track. And then my last audio track is always music, because I don't want it getting messed up with sound effects or anything. So I try to bury that as low as possible with my ambient tracks. Sandwiched in the middle, I said almost sandwich in the middle. I almost said that. Sandwich in the middle are just all different types of sound effects. So if you're not familiar with the editing style using like J cut or L cuts, it's usually tail and beginning portions of audio tracks like overlapping. And then you do little crossfades. So there's never an abrupt hit. That's why there's so many different sandwich sound effects tracks, because I'm always J cutting and L cutting my audio. If you don't know what that is, let me know. I could definitely make a tutorial on it. This is some one-on-one type stuff, but I just want to go over that. And now what we could do is we can do these for every single one of the timelines. So once you have these up, you could add your audio, your video tracks, and then we're just that much closer to saving this as a preset. The last thing I'm gonna mention is if there's any effects that you always use, say like for the voice track, I use a plugin in the Fairlight tab right here called Alex Butler Audio. And essentially it just helps my compression and EQing the voices. It's different plugins. What we could do is we could save the different plugins, or even on the videos, different overlays, whatever, you could drop on as much as you want to create this template. So if I know I'm always using the voice on audio one, why not just have it already there so we could save it? So now that we have, per se, our whole timeline, our project, everything's dialed in. We have our timelines nicely organized. We have our subfolders that we're gonna close up, and we're gonna just click on the master. What I like to do from here is hit Command S, or you could go up to File and hit File Save if you're on PC. However you save it, save it. Now what we could do is go back to our project location. All right, so now that we hit saved, what we could do is go back to the project manager section, and all we have to do to move forward with this, say we're ready, this is our project right here up on the screen, we just opened DaVinci Resolve and we want to create, say, a YouTube video or something like that. What we're going to do is, we're not going to double click on the template, being that this is the template right here, we're going to right click on it and open in read only mode. Being that I just created this, you're not going to probably get this notification, so don't even bother with it. And now, right here, we have our whole template. Everything's set up. What I want you to do is, off the jump, save it. So either go to File, Save. On the Mac, I'm doing Command S. And now I'm going to label this, I don't know, DaVinci YouTube Tutorial Tips and Tricks, right? Then we're gonna save it. It's asking about my cache location. You won't get that message. And now at the top, it changed from the template to the new project that we just saved from the name that we just created. And if I go back to the project manager setting area, notice how we're now on the DaVinci YouTube Tutorial Tips and Tricks. We're no longer inside this template. That's how easy it is. That's how fast it is to create these. And now moving forward, these are just your templates. They're ready to go. You could just start importing your footage, your assets, your music, all that stuff. You don't have to spend 10, 15, 20 minutes every time you boot up Resolve. So that's the first tip. And I know it was long. The next two are pretty quick. If you have a speed editor at home, go pull it up because we're going to be talking about the speed editor. All right, so we moved the keyboard out of the way. We got the speed editor right in front. It's time to start pulling selects. So in my footage folder under FX6, I have some Pennzoil campaign footage with a Formula Drift driver Mike Power that we recently did. And I am selected on my select timeline. What we're gonna do is, instead of the edit tab, we're gonna go over to the cut tab. Have no fear, Jay's here. Just in case you're scared. Now, here is our viewer. On the right, we have our video feed, the left, our clips. And one thing I want you guys to do is, we have a timeline button and we have a source button. We're gonna hit the source button, and up on the screen, now we're seeing the clips populate. Now, underneath the source and timeline button is a shuffle, jog, or scroll button. For precise pulling of the clip, for your in and out markers, I'm always on the jog. But if I want to scrub through really fast, you could use shuffle, you could use scroll. I like the scroll to really find a certain point, but overall, I'm usually going to be on the jog. So how do we pull our selects? Super simple. We have an in and out button on the left side. They're big and white. You can't miss them. And then on the top left, we have smart insert or a pen. I like to use a pen. Sometimes when I do smart insert, it just gets a little funky. I don't know why. I've watched a bunch of videos. It just does. So what I'm gonna do is, using the jog wheel and hitting the jog button so we could really fine tune everything, I'm just gonna spin this wheel. And I'm gonna find a moment, so I wanna start the clip right here. I'm gonna hit in, and then I'm gonna scrub forward with the jog wheel and find a point in which I wanna cut to, which is right, say, after I look down. Boom. So we're gonna hit out, and then we're just gonna hit append. Notice how it just dropped it on the timeline right in front of us. And I'm gonna just sit here, hit in, go right there, append. And I'm just gonna add in and out markers to all the pieces of footage, right? So I'm hitting in, he's pumping and jacking the car up. I'm gonna find another spot, in, out, append, and we're just gonna sit here in, out, append, and we're gonna do this for all the clips or the, all the selects we wanna make, right? We're gonna sit here and just see, like right here, he's just pushing the jack stands in, it's getting down low. And then I know the next clip I have him pull it out and finish the movement again so we could tie in the two clips. And it's that simple. In and out, a pen. In and out, a pen. And you're just sitting there like a DJ, moving through the track, listening for the beat match. But instead of the beat match, you're looking for that fire clip and you're just adding and dropping it, right? Pretty easy for the selects. Now, how do we do the double stack timeline so we could take these selects and throw them up top? I'm gonna show you. Now all we have to do is go back to the edit page and we have our selects dropped on the select folder. What I want you to do is X out of this timeline. It's gonna make sense in just a second. So we got rid of the select timeline and on the right edge of the screen, we have this timeline plus button. Click on that and now being that we enabled our display stack timelines by clicking that, it can add another timeline. You can add a bunch of them. The more you add, the slower the computer gets. Just know that. Now what I could do is go to our second timeline on the bottom, hit this arrow, go to selects, and now my selects are down here. So what I could do is during the edit, right, I could take this and drag it into my hero edit. Both these clips, right? And now could find the timing, we could fine tune it, but it's so simple and easy. You're just throwing down your music track, put your beat markers to it, and now you could just drag and drop. And this right here are three tips in which has improved my editing, my workflow, giving me less time at the desk, letting me shoot more and creating more content. If you use any of these tips, let me know in the comments below. If you use all three, you're a G because you know what you're doing. Let me know in the comments below any other types of tutorials you'd like for me to create, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace.